weeks waiting for the Gemini launch, and I'm in the line.
And there was so many
Hey! Oh, this is so exciting.
Please go on.
I'm shaking.
I don't see it happening, Malcolm.
Because it's a committee of like booksellers and academics who choose the shortlist, but then the Prime Minister chooses the winner. Yeah. And the idea of him sitting there trying to, and someone being like, alright, so there's this girl.
By the way, this book has the word refugee in it about 40 times.
Would you like to give the authors the opportunity to make a speech, Malcolm?
Before we get too far into this, we should say thanks for showing up. Like, this is the first stop of this tour.
Yeah.
And like, seeing all of you come out to see us is mind-blowing. Like, it's an incredible turnout. So thank you so much for being here and making it.
We didn't think this book would get published when we started, and we were actually fine with that. We thought we were doing it for fun, because we thought it was such a weird book that no one would ever publish it.
It only go one of two ways. It was either going to be just too weird for anyone to touch, or just weird enough that people would mistake us for talented. And fortunately, everyone made that horrible mistake. So yeah. Well, this is the second part of that story.
Yeah.
So
it totally
that,
is.
That was only part one.
Yeah.
It's about 6 months in, and Amy walked in one day and said, hey, I had a dream that we wrote a book together.
So I was already co-authoring with Meg Spooner on another series, so I guess like it was in my head. And so I had this dream that I was writing a book with Jay, and I had forgotten what the book was about. Like, it was like that dream you have where you get to school and you didn't know there was going to be a test, and now you're in the test, and now the test is in German, and you're not wearing any pants. And Jay lets me specify I was wearing pants in the dream.
Everyone
was in
pants. We get mistaken for married a lot. And we're both married, but not to each other. There was an incident in a security line at an American airport where this guard turned to me and asked a question about my wife, and it took me a second to pass, like, she's in Australia, my wife. And I looked at Amy and did the math, and Amy arrived at the same conclusion that I did at the same moment, and I swear to God, we both went and jumped physically apart from each other.
When I showed up to brunch and told Jay this, we started like really just for fun, just like knocking around, okay, it's an email book. So why is it a book written in emails? Why are they emailing instead of just talking to each other? And because we're giant nerds, the answer very quickly was because they're in space. The cold vacuum of space is an effective barrier to walking up and talking to one another. So then, okay, so where are they in space? They're on different spaceships, that's why they have to email. Why can't they just take a shuttle across? Because something bad is happening, it's urgent. They're on the run. Why are they on the run? Planet destroyed. Okay, that's getting better. Is it enough? No. Definitely plague as well. Okay, now we're getting better.
So have you guys all seen Mad Men?
Yeah.
I was kind of like Don Draper, but I wasn't an alcoholic or cheating on my wife, but I was Don Draper. And so I had...
I'm realizing you've already told them the story about how you ordered 4 bottles of champagne and got engaged.
I am married, not to Victoria. Happily so, I assure you.
You have Gemma. We're at the end of the line. The last one.
Oh, we actually
made it.
I have a very, very serious question. Would you rather have pineapples for hands or only eat pineapples for the rest of your life?
I would cheerfully only eat pineapples for the rest of my life.
Yeah, life with pineapples for hands would be pretty difficult. Being an author, I imagine, would be particularly
would be quite a drawback. Although with Dragon dictates software these days, not impossible.
Yeah, okay.
Still, I really like pineapples, so yeah. It's a very easy choice.
I know, like, 1 page 259.
I thought you memorized what page you're on.
No, I didn't.
I
Tracy have one of these. So
didn't you give us one of those photos?
That was promised. To be honest though, I did make off with this giant bag of M&M's though.
Yeah,
you
made up with the freckles.
Yeah,
that's
you
nice.
Know.
Why
did you buy this book yet?
Oh, I just made one.
Yeah, okay. Hang on, it's coming.
Do I have any singles?
Yeah. Yeah, it might change dramatically. Yeah. By the time I actually come to it.
Yeah.
So it could be one of a kind.
So what are the sip of the
yeah, sure.
Sure. Everyone ready? Done.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Like,
see, I don't have the US arc of them that.
I've got the Australian one. I've got the Australian
one. Like the one with the two birds on it? Oh, I don't have that one.
Yeah.
Embrace
yeah.
You.
Sorry. Sorry. What are you doing?
Finishing up, we're, as always, we're the last people.
Because
there's always so much room. Leaving now, and it's what, 9?
9:30-ish?
Almost 10 o'clock.
Almost 10.
Oh my gosh, 10 o'clock, guys.
Hi!
Note, we were meant to leave there at about 8:30.
Yeah.
It's 10 o'clock.
Going to start
reading tonight! Yeah. So this is what Rundle Mall looks like at 10 p.m. Now we've got to find our way home. Good night. Peace out.
See ya.